Put simply, Camden 500 is one of the cleanest, most linear and transparent preamps on the market. But when you turn its Mojo dial, it transforms into one of the fattest, warmest and most colourful mic preamps in your arsenal. Preamps are arguably the most important stage in the recording process. And if you look at some of the most popular preamps on the market, whether it be a 19-inch unit, a 500 series module, or even just the preamps built into your audio interface, your audio is often being damaged beyond repair before it even reaches any plugins. Camden 500 offers a perfectly neutral and uncoloured front end that pushes the boundaries of performance and ultimately means that the audio that you capture is the perfect starting place for processing within your DAW. These are all very audacious claims, but they're not claims that we would make lightly, especially without the evidence to back it all up. But if we take a deep dive into their tech specs, hopefully you'll be able to see what I'm talking about. Starting with frequency response, at maximum gain, Camden 500 is pretty flat from way below 5 Hz all the way up to 200 kHz with a maximum of 0.7 dB of roll-off. By extending the frequency response beyond the audio band, Camden 500 is resistant to intermodulation distortion and other interactions, hyping frequencies and colouring the signal. It's well known that transformer-based preamps add their own dramatic EQ character, and that's one of the reasons why people love the sound of them. But even high-end transformerless preamps can start cutting audible frequencies when you start increasing the gain control. We wanted to make sure that Camden 500 achieves accurate frequency response at all gain positions, so that regardless of your source and the gain position required, Camden 500 will remain transparent. Another important factor to a preamp's transparency is phase shift. Phase shift causes certain frequencies to be delayed when they are amplified by a preamp. This can result in sluggish transients, a lack of punchiness, and tonal coloration. Camden 500 exhibits 2.25 degrees of phase shift between 20 Hz and 20 kHz, resulting in instant and lifelike transients at all frequencies and on all sources. Phase shift on some transformer-based preamps can be as much as 90 degrees at 50 Hz, and that essentially means that 50 Hz is delayed by 5 milliseconds as it passes through the preamp. At maximum gain, phase shift on some preamp designs can increase dramatically. Phase shifts are hard to hear in isolation, but when used in multi-mic instances, like around a drum kit for example, it can cause comb filtering and irregularities that go way beyond what a polarity switch would do to help you. Camden 500's absolute maximum phase shift is 4 degrees between 20 Hz and 20 kHz, and that's at 68 dBs of gain. Equivalent input noise, or EIN, measures the noise that the preamp adds onto the input signal. The lower the EIN, the greater the signal-to-noise ratio, and the more processing you can apply in your DAW before noise starts to become audible. Camden 500 has an EIN of less than minus 129.5 dB unweighted with 150 ohm load. Other manufacturers represent EIN with inputs common, input shorted, or A-weighted figures on their spec. But whilst that achieves very impressive numbers, that doesn't really represent the same conditions as a microphone connected to that preamp. If we play by the same rules, Camden 500's EIN performance is less than minus 135.5 dB inputs common, unweighted, which exceeds even the most elite and expensive preamps on the market. Probably the biggest factor to determine a preamp's transparency is THD, or total harmonic distortion. That's what gives a preamp a sound or a colour. THD is a measurement of the harmonic content that is generated by the preamp and added onto the input signal. Highly regarded vintage preamps will have lots of THD thanks to its transformers or valves. And vintage preamps are certainly very well loved even to this day. And so THD figures can be very subjective. However, what is objective with THD measurements is that the smaller the THD ratio, the more transparent the mic preamp, and the less colour, good or bad, is being added to the input signal. Our THD plus N ratio is below 0.0004% at 1 kHz, 24.5 dB again, and it's inaudible at all frequencies between 20 Hz and 20 kHz. Manufacturers often quote THD at one gain setting and at one frequency, usually where the best number is achieved. But THD can vary significantly at different frequencies and gain positions. Camden 500 has completely inaudible THD at all gain settings and at all frequencies. The net result of all of this is that Camden 500 provides the utmost clarity and detail when it's most required. Acoustic guitars sound like they're right next to you. Vocals sound defined and detailed. Drums sound punchy and tight in the low end. DI'd instruments sound clear, smooth and natural, which is something that a lot of preamps struggle with. And perhaps best of all, audio that's captured through a Camden 500 responds really well to processing in your DAW. And multiple Camden 500s play very nicely together thanks to its phase linearity.
Here we stand on the edge, a precipice of doubt before us, one last chance to ourselves we pledge. Leave those behind who lost our trust.
But we're all musicians and engineers ourselves, and we know that there are moments where you want that analog saturation and coloration. So that's why we developed our Mojo circuit. Mojo was designed to introduce the same harmonic and saturation effects that our favourite vintage gear produces, whilst living on a variable control that can be dull to taste and, most importantly, switched off when you don't want it. We came up with two independent saturation styles, Thump and Cream. At low levels, Thump can easily emulate famous British console style preamps in terms of harmonic content and frequency response. At maximum levels, Thump goes well beyond the effects that a transformer could achieve, but it still remains tight and punchy without the muddiness or filter resonance that you would get if you tried to emulate its results with EQ. Cream increases THD and applies smooth and vintage sounding tonal shaping that contain boxy mid-range, make transient sound fatter, room sound bigger, and vocal sound more intimate and almost compressed. When you crank Cream to full, you can also get kind of chewy overdrive effects too.
Comes again, dragging you down, pulling you in. You try to scream, but what is that sound? It's the stranger you hear.
In short, Cream is like a one-stop shop tonal shaper that will help tracks sit nicely in any mix while still being heard. The transparent Camden 500 front end combined with the Mojo circuit means that Camden 500 provides a huge range of tonal possibilities, from ultra clean and modern transparency to big, gritty, vintage warmth, whilst being manufactured in the UK for a lower price than you'd think for a preamp of this performance level. Graphs only tell you so much about how a preamp sounds, but the trick with Camden 500 is that it doesn't sound like anything unless you've added it with Mojo or other processing. It just amplifies your instrument or source material. If you want to find out more, you can check out the Cranborne Audio website for the full tech spec. We can't wait until you get your ears on Camden 500 and hear it for yourself. Thanks for watching.